Hey guys, John, Rock NTV One here. So I am here today to tell you guys that, I don't know about you, but some people think it's women that are yard sale freaks. I'm a yard sale freak, man. I love them. Especially when I find stuff like this. This thing here, I forget what I paid for it. It was probably come with a package deal or some pile of stuff, but believe me, it wasn't nowhere near what you'd pay for it if you had to buy this new. And I'm not even sure that they still make them like this. You know, this is a Starrett surface gauge, model 57B. And I bought it just like this. And hopefully, yeah, let me try to do this so that you guys can see this all right. Hopefully, yeah, you get to see it all right. And, yeah, okay. I mean, this thing is in the original box. I don't know if it had any padding there. A lot of times they come with little, like, burlap cloth stuff. But, yeah. So, you guys work in a machine shop, sometimes you will use either for laying out or for checking parts. This is a surface gauge, Starrett, and it can be used as a height gauge, yeah, or like a comparator for all kinds of things. You could, if you were working on a mill, you could set this on your table and set a tool height or set a part height in a vise. All kinds of things that can be that this could be used for. It is a model 57B. It has the V on the back. Hopefully, you guys, I'm staying in frame for you there. And it's these two pins that you would drive those down with a soft hammer. And those would you'd be able to you know, lock up on the side of your table or yeah, to bring you in the line with something. This particular one came with I got this extra long rod. Yeah, it goes like this in there. And the scribe or pointer, whatever you'd like to call it, the straight one and the curved one. And they are hardened, so if I wanted to, I could, you know, send that thing up to a, you know, a spot, a pre-measured spot that I already had measured that distance, and that way I would know it was right, and then I would come over and make my layout scratch on something. I'm not going to do it on my box, but, yeah, I just wanted to show you guys this thing there because I don't know what year this is, but I gotta imagine by the box that it could be you know, 30s or 40s, possibly 50s maybe. I think this thing is something in the neighborhood of 200 bucks, just under that. And I am kind of glad to have it and that I did not have to buy this at full price. And yeah, you're not gonna see this on eBay for me. I don't sell my tools like this. You know, when I get the good ones, I hold on to them. Yeah, if I have to buy something down to dirty and I need to be cheap on it, yeah, I will buy those cheaper tools, knowing full well that you know, they may or not be perfect on their numbers. They may be close, but they're probably not perfect. A tool like this here, you know, I mean, this thing could be around for 100 years if you don't drop it on the floor or more. Cost, you know, you want to take care of the surfaces and make sure that they don't get guffed up. But there you go. I just wanted to show you my little yard sale acquisition there. And you know, you guys, if you're into this hobby stuff, definitely keep your eyes open. You know, when you show up at these flea markets or whatever, because sometimes stuff like this shows up, and you know, most people, if they're not into machining or anything of the sort, they don't even know what this thing is. So you can get them cheap. So thanks for watching the videos. Please rate and subscribe, and thanks for watching.